Hi guys, this is Dr. MK. Today we are going to discuss what do you mean by ortho-meta paradirectors and what is their role in aromatic electrophilic substitution reactions. So before going to the topic, I would like to ask a question. How will you be able to identify ortho-meta para position of benzene ring? In this compound, all the carbon atoms are equivalent in nature. So it does not have any ortho meta para positions. Understood? Suppose if I give another molecule where benzene is substituted, this is said to be substituted benzene. The substitution can be anything. So I generally give R as a functional group. In this case, that first position, that is substituted carbon, is called as ipso. And the next position is called ortho. And parallelly, this position is also called ortho. And the two carbon atom which is next to ortho position is called meta. And this is also meta. And the last carbon atom, that is a fourth carbon atom, is called as para. So one must understand that simple benzene ring does not have any ortho meta para position, whereas a substituted benzene only will have ortho meta para position. So with this idea, let me go to the topic. When benzene is connected to an electron donating group, say for example, this molecule is called as anisole, where benzene is connected to a functional group called methoxy, which is electron donating group. You may ask, how will you say this is an electron donating group? Because when oxygen is directly connected to a benzene ring or a double bond system, means oxygen is having two lone pairs of electron. So it will easily donate its lone pair of electron to benzene ring, and it is easily considered to be electron donating group. So we will go to the resonance form. So as I said earlier, oxygen has two lone pairs of electron, and one of the lone pairs comes towards the carbon atom, and here the valency is increased. Automatically this electron will move towards ortho position and it will undergo resonance, leading to the formation of this resonance form. Since oxygen has donated a pair of electron, a positive charge is generated. Since this carbon atom accepted a pair of electron, a negative charge is generated. I said already in the last video, when a carbocation or carbanion or free radical which is connected next to that double bond, means it will immediately undergo resonance. So resonance will take place easily. And if you happen to check here, this anion has a pi bond next to the carbon atom. Okay, so it will immediately undergo resonance. So this electron will come here and this electron will move towards the para position. It will lead to the formation of this resonance structure. Since this carbon has accepted a pair of electron, it will get minus charge. If you happen to check the next carbon atom, you have another double bond, so immediately this anion will undergo resonance and the negative charge will form at ortho position. So this is a overall resonance structures one can write for benzene is connected to electron donating group. So if you happen to check, benzene is connected to any electron donating group, means the electron density will be maximum at ortho position and para position, and here also ortho position. Okay, so this is said to be activating group that means electron donating group is otherwise known as activating group or ortho para director. Why I am calling it as ortho para director? Because I said already, when electrophile reacting with benzene, means it needs electron. So the electron density is maximum in the case of ortho position and para position only. So reactivity will be happening at ortho and para positions maximum, and meta position there won't be any reaction. If at all is happening, you will get very very less amount of product. So this is about benzene is connected to electron donating group. Let us discuss when benzene is connected to electron withdrawing group. So let us take this example, nitrobenzene, in which benzene is connected to nitro group. Nitro group is considered to be electron withdrawing group. Why? Because nitrogen is having positive charge. So benzene will try to give the electron towards nitrogen atom. So let us explain with resonance form. So the nitro group should be written like this. So when each N is connected to oxygen by a double bond and a single bond here. So benzene is giving electron, and here the valency will be increased by 1. As a result, this pi electron will move towards oxygen atom, and it will lead to the formation of this resonance form. So since oxygen has accepted a pair of electron, a negative charge is generated. Since this carbon atom of benzene ring donated an electron to this nitrogen atom, a positive charge is generated. So you have a positive charge, next to that you have a double bond. So immediately it will undergo resonance. After resonance, here you will get the double bond is migrated towards this carbon atom. So you will get a positive charge, right? So if you happen to check the next carbon atom, you have one more double bond. So immediately the resonance will take place. As a result, the positive charge will move towards ortho position. So if you compare all the resonance structure, I can give a conclusion in which when nitrobenzene is given, means the positive charge will come at ortho position and the para position and again ortho position. Basically, when electrophile is reacting with nitrobenzene, means it should need electron, but this benzene ring having mostly positive charge only. So this is deactivating the benzene ring. So previously we discussed activating, it is giving electron and thereby it enhancing the electron density of benzene ring. But here this group accepts electron and thereby it reduces the electron density of benzene ring. So this group is said to be deactivating group. So here ortho position is having positive charge. Ortho position is having positive charge and para position also having positive charge. Where the positive charge is not there, you can say meta position. So there is only one possibility, that is meta position only the reaction will take place. That means the meta position will undergo reaction with electrophile. So it is called as meta director. So we can conclude that when electron donating group is present, you can call it as activating group or ortho para director. When electron withdrawing group is there, you can say that is deactivating group and meta director. So that is a conclusion. So let us have more examples. So this is going to be very, very important topic for NEET and JEE students, because questions can be asked. So list of ortho and para directors, otherwise known as activating groups, or you can call it as activators. So the first example is oxygen having minus charge. So this is said to be phenoxide. So oxygen is having minus charge, that means rich in electron, it can give easily electron to benzene ring and it will activate the system. So this is said to be ortho para director. So next example is amine, that is NS2, you can call it as NR2 also. So R can be anything, hydrogen or alkyl group, whatever may be. So here you have a nitrogen lone pair, it will also give electron to benzene ring and it will lead to the formation of negative charge at ortho, para and ortho positions. It is said to be ortho para directors. So next example, you have phenol, that is OH hydroxy functional group, where you have two lone pair of electron. This I have already explained, it is also considered to be ortho para directors. The same example I have discussed, where that is anisole is given, where methoxy is given. So instead of methyl, you can have R. R can be anything, it can be anything. So it can give electron to the benzene ring and as a result it will enhance the electron density at ortho position and para position. So next example we have, that is, this is said to be amide. So this example is very much important, questions can be asked. So where it is said to be amide, so here you have, instead of methyl, you can have any R functional group. So when benzene is directly connected to nitrogen atom, which is carrying lone pair of electrons, so it is considered to be ortho para director. So electron density will be maximum at ortho position and as well as para position. So where the reactivity will take place, that I will discuss in a separate video. So in this video, you have to remember that amide group is an ortho para director, provided the nitrogen is directly connected to benzene ring. So we have another example where it is said to be ester. Instead of methyl group, you can have R group. And here also you can check that oxygen atom which is carrying lone pair of electron directly connected to a benzene ring, it will directly give electron towards the benzene ring and thereby it will enhance the electron density at ortho and para position. So this is also said to be ortho para director and otherwise known as activating group. So we have one more example, this is thiol. Thiol is also a similar case, it has lone pair of electron, it will give electron and thereby it will enhance the electron density at ortho and para position. And this is said to be thioether. Instead of methyl you can have R group, and sulfur also has two lone pair of electron, it will enhance the electron density. So it is said to be ortho para director. And here you have alkyl group. So alkyl means what can be, it can be methyl, ethyl, etc. So I have given one example where it is said to be toluene. So in toluene you cannot expect any resonance form because carbon atom does not have any lone pair of electron, rather you can expect hyperconjugation. I will explain hyperconjugation with a different video. So just understand that it will undergo hyperconjugation, thereby it enhances electron density at ortho and para position. So it is considered to be ortho para director. And finally we have benzene is connected to halogens. What are the halogens? That is fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine. So halogens have three lone pairs of electron. So they are rich in electrons. So they will try to give electron to benzene ring. It enhances the electron density at ortho and para position. But if you compare the rest of the functional group, halogens are not that good donors. They are considered to be poor electron donors because halogens are more electronegative in nature. They are considered to be minus I groups. So it will try to pull the electron towards sigma bond. So also it will try to give electron through pi bond. So it has two characters, that is it will act as a minus R group as well as plus R group. So in this case the minus group will dominate, so it is not that good donor, it is considered to be poor electron donor, but still it is to be ortho para director. So we have another set of example where the meta directors, otherwise known as deactivating groups, are given. So first of all you have anilinium ion where nitrogen is having positive charge. So this is a tricky example. I will put a separate video on this, but still it is considered to be a meta director only. And here you have a nitro group where you have positive charge on nitrogen atom. It will accept the electron, it will decrease the electron density at ortho and para position, and it will increase the electron density at meta position. So it is considered to be meta director. And you have cyano. So cyanide means you have C triple bond N. So here carbon is less electronegative than nitrogen, so the electron cloud will be moving towards nitrogen atom. Nitrogen will get more electron density, that is del minus, and here you have del plus. Carbon atom having partial positive charge, so it is considered to be electron withdrawing group. Next example, this is said to be trifluoromethyl. So this example is so important, remember. Where carbon is connected to three fluorine atoms. We know that fluorine is more electronegative atom, so you will have del minus, del minus, del minus. As a result, here you will have del plus. So carbon is having del plus, so it will be a strong electron withdrawing group and it is considered to be deactivating group. And one more example, this is said to be trichloromethyl. So you can have a 3 chlorine atom. So here you will have del plus and the rest of the chlorine atom have del minus, and it is said to be electron withdrawing group. So these two examples are so much important, they are said to be meta directors. Okay. So we have very much important example, this is said to be carbonyl compounds. Where benzene is connected to C double bond O. So when you compare the electronegativity, oxygen is more electronegative than carbon atom. So here the electron density will be maximum del minus, here the electron density will be less. So it is said to be del plus. So it will be acting as electron withdrawing group since carbon having positive charge. So it will act as electron withdrawing group. So it is said to be meta director, because ortho and para position will have positive charge. So meta only will have more electron density. So we have so many examples where you have aldehyde, ketone, ester, acid and amide. So you can check here in the previous slide I explained ester and amide are ortho para director, but here also I am giving explanation that ester and amide also considered to be meta director. So you must understand the difference when amide nitrogen is connected to benzene, means it is said to be ortho para director, whereas in amide the carbonyl system is connected to the benzene ring, means it should be called as meta director, because this is electron withdrawing group and it is said to be electron donating group. So we have a final example. This is sulfonyl system. It can be redrawn like this also. So yes, double bond O, O. See, so yes, it is similar to that of carbonyl system. It will accept the electron and thereby it will decrease electron density at ortho and para position. So it is said, considered to be meta director. We have a final examples. Anisole is given and it is treated with nitration condition. So I already explained that when nitration is given, means the electrophile involved is nitronium ion, and here you have methoxy group which is said to be ortho para director. So the reaction will take place at ortho position and para position. So you will get the major product at para position. In ortho position will be minor one. The reason is ortho position means you have a steric hindrance. So at normal condition, major product will be para product and the minor product will be ortho product. So we have a final example in which nitrobenzene is given, whereas the nitro group is said to be meta director and it is reacting under the condition of nitration. So as a result, nitronium ion will form. It will directly react with meta position. So you will get meta as a major product. Still ortho and para will be forming, and that will be considered to be minor amount, very less amount it will form. So guys, hope you understood the difference between ortho para directors and the meta directors and their role in aromatic electrophilic substitution reaction. If you find the video is very much useful, give a like, share with your friends, and do not forget to subscribe the channel. And I will meet you all guys with an interesting topic. Until then, take care, bye.